everybody, it's Maggie from Personal Euphoria. So I had a request to make a video of exercises you can start with for your core when you feel like you have no core strength. And sometimes, yes, people have no core strength. Sometimes I think it's just a matter of finding it. If no one's ever taught you really what your core is or how to make sure that's what's working, then you're not sure if you're doing the right thing. So we're gonna go over a few things, but I also think a lot of the time when people think core, they think abs. And our core is not just limited to our abs, it is like our whole supportive structure of our trunk. So that includes your abs, your butt, your back, and your shoulder girdle. So I'll give you at least an exercise to start with for all of those places. So that will hit every part of the core, and you do wanna work it all. We are gonna start with the abs. So if ab work is new to you, one of the places to start is actually a little bit tricky to find. It's not like it's so simple and easy, but you wanna be able to, you can sit or stand, that doesn't matter, but you wanna be able to engage and release your lower abdomen, so pubic bone to belly button. And you wanna be able to engage and release that on command and feel like there is movement in your lower abs. Now, very often people can kinda like suck in at their ribs and draw in up here. This should be low. And I often cue, imagine zipping a pair of skinny jeans fresh out of the dryer after eating Thanksgiving dinner. It's from pubic bone to belly button, very low. If you can do a Kegel on command, those muscles will activate automatically and you might feel that. If you've ever had an abdominal surgery or a C-section, feeling that connection might be tricky, so play with it. Try not to get frustrated if you don't feel it coming right away. Keep trying to engage and release really subtly, because you release and then you engage. But it's not so much that you're like sucking in and bearing down. And it shouldn't move your bone, so it shouldn't tuck your tailbone under. You can do this all the time, playing with it. When you inhale, you wanna let it go and take a comfortable breath, let your stomach expand, but on any exhale, you wanna try to gently draw in and feel tautness here. Now, I know this is more complicated, so if you have more questions about this, I actually have a couple of YouTube videos that go into more depth about this if you want more information on what I call the zip of the jeans. But that is without a doubt one of the best things you can start to do to activate your core muscles, because it engages your deepest ab muscle. You can do it anytime, anywhere. And once you find it, it's really supportive for low back. So if you don't want the low back pain, or if you have low back pain, learning to zip your jeans is important. So that's one thing to play with. Next, let's break down a couple of ab exercises, because very often people try to do ab work, but what happens is either their neck hurts or their hips hurt, and they're kind of bypassing the abs. So for ab work, let's talk about what a lot of people think of for a basic crunch. When people curl up to do a crunch, usually without thinking about it, their low back crams into the floor and their muscles actually push up to the ceiling. So one of the things we want to focus on when you do a crunch, or in Pilates we call this ab prep, is keeping a neutral spine. So you keep a slight arch in your low back. And you're just gonna curl your head and shoulders off and try not to let that back cram into the ground. You're trying to draw in and zip those jeans like we just talked about. So it's a smaller move because you won't get anything higher than your shoulder blades. And when you start, you might not even get that high, but you wanna feel not just the center of your abs, but the sides of your abs. All right, so you wanna feel like everything doesn't push upward when you curl up. You are drawing gently up on your pelvic floor, doing a Kegel, and gently zipping those jeans to kind of keep the abs active as you curl. Now, oftentimes people feel the neck, and sometimes that could be because you have an issue or because your abs don't feel strong enough yet and the work is coming into the neck instead. So you don't wanna cram the chin to the chest, and you also don't want it dangling out here. Before you lift, you do a little head nod. So you slightly tuck your chin so that naturally when you curl up, your gaze is sort of at your knees. Chin either too crammed or way back here or jutting forward. Very often people try to pull their head forward. And you need to think of like letting the head just rest where it is. But that's more work on the abs. Your head is jutting forward to try to put more weight over here and take it away from out here. So better to do 3 or 4 really quality ab work and make sure you feel your abs and not your neck and slowly build up than to crank out 10 and by 8 know that your neck is really sore. So you would always start with a little head nod, nod the chin to the chest, then curl up and lengthen down. My hands are not pulling my head, they're supporting the weight of my head. Trying to actually resist me doing this yanking forward, but like being a little place I can rest my head against, okay? And when you do that crunch, you'll feel where the abs connect to the ribs, but also if you're thinking of zipping the jeans, you'll feel your obliques on the sides a little bit more. Next, we're gonna work from the other end because a lot of people wanna be able to do like a full sit-up, but they tend to cheat and they throw themselves up. So we do what we call the half rollback. And in that move, I'm gonna have you start sitting tall and you're gonna tuck the tailbone and roll back. You are trying to get the hips to pull away from your thighs, creating space here and rolling back. And then we're actually gonna curl and stack back up. And then initiate from that pelvis, dialing your pelvis back like an old radio dial, pulling those abs in and come back up. Now, a lot of people, just to sit here, it's so tight that their hips won't release, and then you can't find your abs. So if this is new to you, or you're really tight in either the hips or the back, they might get in your way. So you'd want to sit on something that has enough room you can roll back on. You want to get your butt a little higher in the air. And then you might find that there, now you... It'll feel easier because these other muscles aren't screaming at you, but you're gonna actually get more effective ab work. So just because we say easier here, it's like a happy start position and then come back up. If you don't have anything that you can prop yourself up on, you can always start with like a chair, all right? And you're gonna sit sideways on it so you have room to go back to take your legs even more out of the equation. Also, if it has a back, you can kind of hang on to it and give your abs a little support, but you're gonna, again, initiate from the abs. So what do you feel leading the motion? Are you squeezing your butt and trying to tuck under? Keep the butt relaxed. Think of your abs pulling you back, pulling these hip bones further away from the thighs. Round that low back and you go back as far as feels comfortable and safe on the chair for you. And then you're gonna start to round forward and come back up. So initiate with that pelvis. I see people are commenting, but I can't see what you're saying from here. So I'll check and answer any comments at the end. Initiate with that pelvis, pull away from your thighs. And right now, I feel my abs. That's what you're looking to feel. And if you don't, if you feel the hip flexors, if you feel the butt, if you feel the low back, this might just not be the right exercise for you right now. But again, play with getting your hips higher. And then eventually you can always go back to trying it on the floor and see, can you get that control here, right? Because you wanna be able to tuck the tailbone. You can also try straight legs. Sometimes that's enough of a release to enable people to move from here. All right, so those are actually 3 ab exercises. Zip the jeans, ab prep, or what you're probably familiar with as a crunch, and a version of the half rollback. So we're working the abs from a couple different ends there. Now, we also wanna work the glutes. They are a huge part of our core. So one of the basic places that's usually the easiest to start without hurting anything, because it's very easy for butt work to wind up in our low back, is to do a shoulder bridge. You'll lie on your back, gaze straight up to the ceiling, arms relaxed at your sides. Your heels are beneath your knees, maybe a smidgen further away. You can play with that. You're gonna stay neutral. So you're keeping that arch in the back and you're gonna press the butt up. You're trying to get a straight line, knees, hips, head, but you might not come that high. And you'll drop the butt down. And you lift up and you drop down. Now, it's the same with every exercise. What do you feel? right? We want to feel this in the butt and probably the hamstrings. So if you squeeze your butt before you even lift, squeeze it and then lift, you're going to get added glute work, right? If you feel it in the back, chances are you are arching the back to come up and you're trying to press with your back instead of your butt. So usually the fix to that is to try not coming up so high at first. Squeeze the butt. Don't worry if you lift up as high. Also, another trick to get the butt to activate, before you even begin to lift, connect your heels into the floor. Start to push the heels down. You'll feel your hamstrings right away. Then you squeeze the butt and lift up. Keep that pressure down and lower the hips down. Also look to make sure you aren't sliding away so that the butt doesn't get further away from the heels. So when you come up, reach out those knees. Think of the weight shift reaching out the knees and staying over your feet. Okay, so you could play with that a little bit and you can build up to 2 sets of 10, starting with whatever feels right for you. Now, we're gonna work the upper back and shoulder girdle a little bit. So this one is also very subtle, but it's a hard one for most people to get because very often those subtle small moves that really teach us where to move from are the harder things to connect with. So I'll show you this both sitting or lying flat on your stomach. You might find one variation easier to connect with, but they're hard in their own way. You could do this standing too. So if sitting's not comfortable, you could do it sitting in a chair. Any way that you can start in a comfortable starting position, be there. But you want to be able to start tall. You don't want to be starting from here and try to move from where we're about to move. So you sit up as tall as you can. Now you can use your hands or if you're not comfortable here, just your hands on your stomach. Part of the goal is to make sure that your stomach and low back don't do the movement. So your stomach and low back stay stable. Your neck doesn't do a big swing. So the move doesn't primarily come from the neck. It comes from the ribs. It's like the reverse of that little crunch we just did. You're gonna try to bend back just by moving your upper back and ribs, and your head just goes for the ride. And then you straighten back up to tall. So from the ribs up is where I am moving my back. I'm not arching my low back any more than it already is, right? You could put your hands on your waist. Make sure that does not move as you bend back and lower. And the biggest mistake, because getting a back bend up here, we are so used to being here all day that it's hard to reverse that. So our neck does a lot of the work and the low back tends to do a lot of the work. Try to keep those ends as still as possible. Know that this is really small. This is the move and you should feel it right across the bottoms of your shoulder blades, maybe a little higher, maybe a little bit lower, but roughly there. You can then try that same move lying on your stomach. So my legs are straight and relaxed. And my hands are relaxed on the floor, but I don't use my hands. It's not like a push-up. I'm not pressing up here. I'm trying to just bend back from the rib cage up and lower down. And bend back and lower down. Bend back and lower down. Now, you might have the flexibility and even the strength to come up this high using your low back. But again, we check in with what you feel. If you feel it in the low back, even though that feels like a bigger move, it must be better. Try to break it down and do a smaller range of motion and get the upper and mid back to do the work. All right, finally, another one that you can do seated, and you can sit Taylor style. You could sit legs straight as long as you could sit upright. Or you can do this one from your office chair or any chair. But again, we want to be tall. And we're going to reach the arms out. You keep your height and you're going to twist deeper and come back to center. Now to the other side, twist deeper. Keep alternating sides here. Your goal is to stay tall. So you don't want to be like crunched over here doing this move. You want to get that long height, and now we're working the obliques with the back and the muscles of the shoulder girdle. So we're combining all our postural muscles to get you to do this move. all working. The abs are on their long end, but they're twisting you, and they twist you more, and they twist you more. You're gonna let your head go with you and look over your shoulder. And for some variety on this, and to get a little more work in that shoulder girdle, you bend the arm that's going back and lead with the elbow, twist, bend the arm that's going back and back to center, twist, think of getting taller. Remember, you're really working not to move from that slump, right? We never want to do this from here. We only want to do it from here, which means you've got to get tall enough or get your butt high enough that you're comfortable doing that, which might mean for you starting standing. Now, I know I'm only kneeling, but I'm afraid you want people to see me. So you could stand, try not to let your hips twist, and twist just through that torso and back to center. Twist, making sure those hips point forward and back to center. If you have a mirror on the first couple, watch and make sure the pelvis doesn't go with you, right? That stays put. Twist, two, three, and back to center. All right, so that's a starting point, and you'll have worked every part of your core, right? So we're gonna zip the jeans. We're gonna play with that crunch, unless you can't figure out how to get it out of your neck right now. We're gonna play with that half roll back, looking for work in the abs, not the hip flexors. We're gonna do a shoulder bridge, looking for work in the butt and hamstrings, not the back. Then we're gonna play with working to bend that upper back. You can do that seated, standing, or lying on your stomach, but you wanna feel that the work comes in your upper and mid back. And then we're gonna do that spine twist, which incorporates a little bit of everything. We're working the obliques, the back is keeping us upright, and we add that twist, and the bent elbow will get your shoulder girdle even a little bit more. So those are some starting points, but always remember, what's most important is what you feel. If you go to do an exercise and you're not feeling it where you're supposed to be feeling it, we've got to change something. And that might, there might be a slightly different trick in everyone's body in order to resolve that. But I hope I at least answered some of the common questions that end up coming up. But people always want big moves. They want to be able to do a full roll up. You will not get stronger if you do big moves, but use the wrong muscles. You'll be doing that muscle, putting your body at risk without gaining strength. If you take it a step back, prop yourself up higher. People think it's a modification, it's making it too easy, but that's how your body's gonna find the right muscles to make the most change and make the most change faster. So if you make it seemingly easier for your body will make changes faster and get stronger faster. You've got to enable your body to move from the right place and learn how to do that. All right, so if you do have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them, or I will try to make another video if there's a question that seems broad enough. But otherwise, keep moving, keep playing, always picking moves that feel good in your body, nothing that hurts. Have a great day.